Anything special about today's bench?
Not a lot special about training in general right now. It's all pretty light, but it is my main bench day, so there will be a heavy-ish single somewhere in there. Yeah.
Fucking, let's pull kilos.
God damn it.
You can use a deadlift bar and power plates. What are you thinking? And straps. Come on, now.
Bumpers, and hundreds on the outside. Yeah. I do really, really good on first and second, and then that third and final pull, it's like a cliff. It's perfect trajectory, and then done.
I haven't had a deadlift session with anybody else in probably like 3 years.
Get tall at the top, we'll get head up tall. Full top. Fucking deadlift with you two and not pull over 600. I was gonna be good and just get some deadlifts in and be nice to my elbow. Then I asked this guy what he's doing and he's like, oh, you know, just gonna work up to your max and rep it. So then I'm like, well, fuck, I gotta step it up. And then Chris is gonna come in and pull over 6 conventional. So now I have to go over 6. Fuck my elbow and my elbow pain. We just gotta pull over 6. Goal just set. Over 6. 650 would be nice. But you know, you never know what happens in a team training environment. Yeah. Especially when you don't have a plan, you don't have a goal. Everybody else goes big, I'll go big too.
And that's what you get when you're training here. You have to go big, gotta put up big numbers, gotta keep the intent high.
Four count down, 3 count pause, and but I only have to do 4 sets of 2.
Oh.
Yeah, because he's being nice.
Oh.
It's amazing.
Is being nice the best thing though?
Why did we change it from 4 sets of, you had me at like 4 sets of 4, and now I'm at 4 sets of 2. What was the reason for the change?
Yeah, just to make you lift heavier weights because you're close to your meat.
Yeah.
Get used to handling heavier weights and controlling the weight, not rushing and going slow.
I'm turbo leg. Ed Cohn calls me turbo leg. Starts off slow and then it goes.
Yeah, 3/4 of an inch. Just a small deficit, just to get a little more range out of it.
How's it feeling?
Ask anybody. I don't care about feelings. I care about how it feels. It doesn't matter how it feels. Hey Charlie, what's my thoughts on feelings and weight?
Oh, yeah. Feelings don't matter. And if I have feelings, I go talk to Brady Cable. That's exactly what he told me to my face.
I don't know how I became the go-to for that, but here we are.
Next that I found hidden in here.
Wait, what?
I went to go grab this collar.
Oh, that's my last one.
Oh, is that yours? Oh, no, it's not. I was just like, oh, here's a collar, and I was like, what a surprise! There's candy! I don't think I'm going to eat it. I might eat the saltwater taffy, actually. Not the jelly beans, though, because someone touched those.
Yeah.
Safety squat bar setting on the transformer bar. And then I'm going to do log. And a bunch of leg stuff. All right, now I'm just warming up with BFR. So, great way to warm up. I love warming up with BFR. Just gets those muscles activated a lot faster.
Yeah.
Headphones are coming on in a few minutes.
There you go.
That's where my work is set. And I have to turn it up really loud to drown out everything that's happening over here. Yeah. I'm like singing over over here, and then everything out here is like.
Are you more suited to conventional, just build-wise, leverages?
Yeah. Yeah. And I mean, the best sumo I've ever pulled was six. I don't really know what I was doing, you know, like, it's kind of like a hybrid sumo stance. And I get here and I still pull. Instead of getting upright, I still pull like I'm pulling a conventional lift. So I don't really know what I'm doing with sumo. Okay.
551. 551 at 0.33. A little bit of power, a little bit of range of motion, a little bit of distance, and bar path.
Main reason I'm doing stop and go or stop and reset is because I just really need to dial in my setup. It's a lot easier to do touch and goes. Touch and goes are notoriously easy. That would have been a really easy setup vibe doing touch and goes. You can kind of get a little balance, get a little bit more advantageous of a start. But at the same time, resetting each time helps it dial in your setup a lot more. It's more practice in what you actually need to do. You're not doing touch and go reps in the meet. You're doing stop and reset or singles. So you got to dial in that setup.
So look at your bar path, rep.
Get a little slow, be able to hear this.
So your best rep, your second, your third was your fastest. First rep was forward. Second rep was almost perfectly straight, had a little hook at the top. Third had a big pull back.
Not trying to go fast. Yeah. The last quite a while, my bench has felt not so great, but trying to just work back up to like tolerating heavy benches again and dialing in the same technique and repeatability that I've had when it felt good. So just accumulating good quality volume, doing some sixes, then I'll do a back off single or like 330, 340.
So. Do you have a meet your grade for?
No, they're all canceled right now. At least all the USAPL ones are in this state.
Are you gonna go to USPA?
I don't know. I keep getting a lot of pressure too. Everybody standing over there wants me to. And we got a lot of USPA competitors here, so it'd be kind of fun to actually go compete with people again.
It's funny when you like come up to somebody, like you just walked up to Brandon, I don't know who the other guy was, but he was like, and it was the best thing.
So what are you doing today?
Deadlifts. Deadlifts. It's literally what Brady was benching is my deadlift right now. Oh. And it's like the worst feeling ever.
Yeah. Why is it so light?
Thanks, Ron. Appreciate it.
Well, I mean, you're obviously not working up to a max.
No, right? It's only like 75%, like 3x5. So, I mean, it shouldn't be all that heavy anyways, but appreciate the support.
To do 606.27.
Let's go, stay in there. Let's go to work. Oh. Thank you. like Mercer grips, just throw them right
exactly.
on a guy.
Exactly. Yeah, I like about Mercer is as they age, I've seen the Velcro pop. And before I was like, well, whatever. But after this, I'm like, no, we're not popping Velcro.
Yeah.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Session, maybe we'll actually put a real plate on there and pull some little red shit. Look at that. We're gonna put 700 on trying to get it over with right now.
They've worked up till this point. Every time I hip in the top though, the barbell just pops out, or the straps just pop off every time I hip in the top. It's actually a pretty easy double. It didn't feel that difficult at all. But they just keep popping off at the top, unfortunately, so just need a new pair.
They work the same and you can just grab them like that, but they tend to lock in a lot better and the fabric probably has more grip to it than the Versus do.
I can see that.
So mess around with something like that. You can try these sometime if you want to do it too.
That sounds good. I got one more back off set of five, so I can do that.
Yeah. Some weightlifter made them, but you can buy these anywhere.
Okay.
Single loop.
Yeah. What was the mitts?
700.
Oh, really? You
went on the dot.
I thought you were just going up to 650 or something.
I was. But I had to attempt to outpull him.
Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Because I wanted bragging rights for the day. And then I looked at the chart, because 670. Whatever it was, 671,
yeah,
moved so well. I was like, well, there's not much in there, but it's only like 14 pounds per side. I look at the chart and I always go over 700. Well, 282.5, whatever it is. Sorry, 317 something. Yeah. Kilos is exactly 700 on the dot.
Oh.
So there is a chance to go 700. I said, I got this. I've never tried 700 before, because I always go over 700. 705, 707, yeah. 722, 711. I missed all those. And now I can add 700 on the dot to that. But 671 moved pretty well. So a week ago, I pulled 651 real easy. We'll take it.
Yeah.